Hello, I'm going to help you get into Ayrshire College's email system, and we use Office 365. So let's get ready for learning at Ayrshire College. So the first thing that you need to do is go to your private email address. Now, I want you to find an email or a text that was sent to you from the college after you applied for your course. Because when you click that button down the bottom of the screen, apply now, we then sent you a response. And in that response that was sent to your private email address, you will find some characters that we need to be able to get into an email, Office 365. Now, I've highlighted the characters in yellow on the screen. So the correspondence you received from the college was probably looks a little bit like this, where it mentions student reference and the course that you've applied for. This one is actually from a letter that was sent out for induction. But the important information that you're looking for is highlighted in this example in yellow. It won't be in yellow in your letter. I've just made it yellow here so that you understand what to look for. It's a capital A with some numbers after it. Okay, I'd like you to write that down. Okay, have you written it down? It's important that you write it down because I want you to take a picture of it and write it down, so because we're going to use it in a wee moment to get into your email. Okay, so now that you've written it down, I'd like you to add the following at the end of that number or code: the at symbol ayrshire.ac.uk, and what you've just created is your email address. That will stay with you all through your studies at Ayrshire College. Okay, so have you written it down? Excellent. Okay. Again, take a picture of it. Keep it safe and keep it easy to find if you ever forget it. Okay, so in this example, what we did there was we went to our private email address to find the correspondence from the college. We looked for our student reference number. It's highlighted in yellow in my example, but it won't be highlighted in yellow in yours. It'll just have an A and then a number. That uniquely identifies you in our system. And what we did was add at Ayrshire College, at Ayrshire, sorry, .ac.uk after it. Okay, that's our email address. Now we're going to create a password. And to create a password, we're going to use a date of birth, your date of birth. In this example, I'm using the date of birth of somebody that was born on the 16th of the 9th, 1978. So what you need to do is take the first six digits. Now, it's important that you drop the 19 at the beginning of 1978, 1981, 1995, whatever your birthday is. And also note, if the month is less than 10, you need to put a zero in front of it. And that'll be true for any day. So in this example, using the 16th of the 9th, 1978, I write down 16, 09, 78. And here's the important part that you should remember. The next character is a capital A, a lowercase b, and a c. Then an asterisk, and you can find the asterisk above the letter, sorry, the number 8 on your keyboard. Okay, let me show you another example just so it's clear what you have to do to create your password. Imagine somebody's date of birth was the 4th of January 1995. That would require a 0, then a 4, then a 0, then a 1, then just the 95. Remember, you have to put the 0, then the 4 because it's less than 10. It's expecting six numbers going in there. Okay. So at the bottom of the screen, you can see it's 040195, and again those four characters, capital A, lowercase b, lowercase c, and then an asterisk. Okay, so let's go back to our example. We have an email address and we have a password. Write them down, take a picture of it. Now this password you're going to use the first time you log in, but we strongly suggest that you change it as soon as possible. Think about it. If somebody knows your birthday, it could actually be quite easy for them to guess your password. We don't want that, and you don't want that. So we recommend, strongly recommend, that after you get in, you change your password and update it to something that nobody can guess and only you would know. Okay, here's the next step. I want you to open up a browser. You can do that on your phone or your tablet or your computer. And I want you to search for Office 365. Of course, you could always just type in www.office.com. Okay, search for it, and then I want you to click the link that says Office 365 login or go to the page. So here's the page you'll see when you arrive there. Don't worry if the gentleman sitting at his sofa has changed and it's somebody else. The website is the correct one, www.office.com. Okay, so don't worry if it says you're signed out. It's saying that to me because I practiced a couple of minutes ago, so I know it works. Okay, so take the email address that you wrote down and now put it in that box. Remember, no spaces, no dots at the end. Just make sure you get it exactly as you wrote it down. And then I want you to click sign in. Okay. Terrific. If you see this screen, you've done the right thing. Don't worry if you don't see this screen. Just go back and check that you got the number correct from your email, and then you wrote it down correctly, and then try again. Okay, what's great is it's coming up with the Ayrshire College logo here. So we're on the right track. I'd now like you to enter the password that you took a note of. So in this example, I'm about to enter 160978, capital A, B, C, asterisk. You enter your own one. Okay, you ready? You then click sign in. Now, what do I do if I see this message? Well, don't panic. It's just about getting some more information to keep your account secure. So, we're going to click next. So, as I say, don't panic. If you see another screen, you're thinking, I'm not in yet, what's happened? Look, we're still in Ayrshire College, but we're trying to keep your information safe. We want to take every precaution to keep your personal information safe and secure. We don't want anyone other than you accessing your email. So what's going to happen is we're going to set up some security questions. You might think, well, this is a bit of a fuss, but it is very, very helpful in keeping you safe and secure and your information safe and secure. So what you get is five questions, and I've actually selected the questions that I want, and there's a drop down. What I haven't shown you is my answers, what my favourite movie is, or my favourite food. It was macaroni, by the way. Anyway, you pick your own answers to these questions. And then click the bottom to say save choices, I think it says there, the very bottom in blue. Okay, so now it's saying, okay, these five security questions have been configured. That just means saved. So we're going to click finish. Now, you're going to see a window that says, do you want to stay logged on? Well, that really depends on the device that you're using. If you're in college and using a computer that other people can access, I would suggest that you don't click no. In fact, definitely don't click no, because somebody else could come along if you leave that browser open and look at your email. If you're working at home or you're using your phone or your tablet, yeah, you probably do want to click yes. If you're working at home and saving your sharing the computer with somebody else, that's up to you. You might want to click no there, or you might want to leave it open. Anyway, you pick the choice that works for you. That's it. We're in. If you see this window, it worked. Welcome to Office 365 and your Ayrshire College email. Okay, the arrows pointing to the right, so I'm going to click there. And this has just given me a kind of welcome and given me an idea of what Office 365 can offer. Eventually, after I click the right arrow a couple of times, I see this window. Now, it's saying, good afternoon, Annie. So this was set up as an example, and the person's name was Annie. So good afternoon, Annie. Makes sense? So if you got this far, you've arrived. This is Office 365. This is your college email. You're in. Now, it can help you in so many different ways, and there'll be another video to show you how it can help you. But look at the icons down the left-hand side under the house. They're all the things that you're familiar with that you used to have to buy and put onto a computer. Now you can access it through Office 365, which is web-based. So you have access to Microsoft Word, PowerPoint, Excel, a whole host of different things that the college are providing for you free. Okay, so what if you're still having problems? You're probably asking, where can I find help? Okay, what I'd like you to do is go to your browser and type in www.ayrshire.ac.uk. Okay, look at the blue line at the top that says students, schools, employers, and commercial. I want you to click on students. And you see this, a menu coming down. Right, click on student support. I've highlighted it in this screen. When you've clicked on it and you scroll down, you'll see ICT as a window. There's a keyboard there. You can see it on the screen. I want you to click on it. Welcome to the ICT support section, it says. So scroll down a little bit, and then you'll see lots of ICT guides. Now, these are terrific guides that can take you through step by step with more detail than I've gone through here. Each feature of getting into a computer and perhaps changing passwords and resetting passwords. So it's a really useful link to know about. Okay, we'll have more videos to help you with Office 365 very soon, but something I need you to remember. The first time you log in, just as we've done here, you're using your date of birth. Please, please, please update your password as soon as possible. Because I could probably, if I know your birthday, I might be able to guess your password. So, you're in Office 365. The really useful link that you want to use is on the college website under Students and then Student Support. There's a section there with lots of different aspects on making changes to your password, downloading Office, Microsoft Office if you want to, or resetting your password. I hope these are all really helpful for you as you try to navigate learning this year. And that's us finished. So thank you very much for listening and good luck with logging in. And please keep an eye on the website because we'll create more videos that can help you with online learning. Okay, thanks very much. Bye bye.